Hi, everybody on Facebook. This is Ashley Swift, and I'm the founder of Three Little Birds for Life. And today we are with Alexis Young here at Vibe Yoga, and we are going to do our second episode of the Chirp tonight, which is going to be a full yoga class streamed online on Facebook. So I wanted to kind of introduce Alexis, and she's going to give some benefits of yoga and talk a little bit about her studio. So Alexis.
Thank you. So I'm so excited to have you guys here tonight. We have been open since June of last year, so we're going into our second year. We have classes all from beginner friendly to a super hard workout. You can find us online. I don't know, we'll add the link if you guys are looking for classes. I have worked with several recovering cancer patients that have limited mobility in their arms and just are trying to get back to, you know, normal life after everything. So I've definitely experienced some healing with yoga. There are many benefits from yoga. You can obviously increase your strength in your core. It lowers your blood pressure. It can help with weight management, improve digestion, improve circulation. So I know a lot of people have problems with neuropathy and stuff after, you know, going through chemo and their fingers, so it can help with that circulation. Body detoxification, so detoxing all of those chemicals out, coming in and having a good sweat, that's always a plus for anything, even if you aren't dealing with something like that. Pain and tension relief, so if you're resting a lot, coming in and making sure you're stretching out those sore muscles and getting everything back into mobility, so that's always super important. Increasing your flexibility, improving your posture, and increasing your immunity. So that's always really important too when you're trying to get better. You want to have a good immune system. So we're going to go through a class. I teach Hatha. So if you guys are new to class, we're just going to be holding poses for longer periods of time for more breath. If you're familiar with down dog or child's pose, you can take those at any time when you're uncomfortable. Just find yourself there, take a few breaths, and just move back into class. I will be explaining everything. I do have a few new people in class today, so if I get off my mat, I'll be right back to show you guys what I was talking about. But we're going to have fun. We're going to focus on our breath, focus on a little stress relief, and just have a good workout. So I'm excited to have you guys. We're gonna go, I'm gonna awkwardly turn to the side. So I'll try to keep eye focus with you guys too. And if you wanna comment or question anything, we can try to answer those as we're going.
Perfect. And then really quick, we have a couple events I wanna talk about. So we have our launch party, Wishiversary party coming on July 27th. It is going to be at the loading dock and it's free. Families are invited, so come celebrate kind of our 6 year Wishiversary on that time. We also just are going to launch tonight that with Italian Fest on September 22nd, we are going to be hosting an inaugural bike ride. And so that's going to be really exciting. So stay tuned for some info that that's going to be family friendly also, where we're gonna do a short bike ride. It's $10. You get a free t-shirt with that. And then I'll post the link of registration for that. And then we are planning on doing different Chirp episodes every other Tuesday. So those will be discussion-based and activity-based. So stay tuned for the other new episodes. So Alexis, take it away.
And actually it might be good to angle it.
Like, Chirp.
Right at that pole, just so it's coming towards me. Everybody in one. So thank you guys for being patient with that. Yeah, maybe a little bit of that. Okay, that's good. Cool. So we're going to go ahead and find a nice tall seat. Rolling our shoulders down our backs. Engage your core. Bring your chin parallel to the mat. Closing your eyes. We're going to place our left hand on our heart, our right hand on our belly. Spending the next few moments focusing on our breath. Breathing in through your nose, filling yourself all the way up to your collarbones. The hand on your heart will rise. As you exhale, it will fall back down and the hand on your belly will come up. Just in your nose, out of your nose. If you would like to set an intention or a reason for being in class this evening, you can go ahead and do so now. Sending your love or your energy to someone or something that may need it more. Bringing your attention back to your breath, drop your hands to your knees, taking your chin to your chest. Do a nice slow neck roll in each direction. Just noticing how you feel. Finding a nice tall seat when you're finished. Inhale, your fingertips up overhead, fingertips come to the ceiling. Exhale, a hinge from your hips down, you can come to a block or the ground, keeping a nice long spine. Stay rooted in your seat, breathe into your tight spot. Maybe fingertipping up just a little further here if you're comfortable. Focus on pushing your chest towards the mat, not rounding your spine. Just let your hips melt into the mat. Deep belly breaths over your leg. Definitely rely on your block here if you need it. Drag your hands back to your body, right? We're going to switch the cross of our legs, finding that nice tall seat in between. Inhale, your arms back up. Exhale, down. Nice long spine. Breathe into your tight spot. Opening your hips to the mat. Fingertip out if you're comfortable. Use your block if you need it. If you notice that one knee is coming up off the mat more than the other, you're welcome to walk yourself over that knee. Whatever feels good to you. Few more rounds of belly breath. Drag your hands back to your body. Rise with your head back. We're going to extend our legs out in front, flexing our toes. You're more than welcome to grab a strap, strapping the bottom of your toes. Flex your toes, bring your shoulders over your hips, engaging your core. Take a deep breath in. As you exhale, hinge from your hips down, working on bringing your chest to your knees. Allow your head and neck to fall. If you have a strap, elbows come up and out. Each exhale, breathe your chest closer to your knees. This is called head to knee pose. You should feel this down the back sides of your legs. Slowly coming up. Swing your legs behind. Stack your shoulders up over your wrists, knees or hips width distance apart. We're going to do a few rounds of cat-cow, starting with cat. Take a deep inhale, tucking your belly button towards your spine, arch your back, send your chin to your chest as you push yourself away from your mat. Exhale and allow your belly to drop. Your head to come back and your eyes to follow as if you're going to look behind yourself. And just keep that going at your own pace. With your own breath. Warming up your spine. wherever you're at, give me one to two more rounds of applause. And the add a neutral spine position. We're going to extend our left leg out, hip high, foot is flexed. You can stay right here, or if you're feeling confident, you can bring up the right arm. Tighten your core, reach your limbs out into the opposite direction, focusing on your breath. You need to curl your back right toe underneath to help you with balance. Tighten your belly button towards your spine. Couple more rounds of deep belly breaths. Lower back down. Shake your hips out, left to right. Coming to stillness. We're going to extend the right leg out, hip high, foot is flexed. Stay here, or bring up the left hand. Tighten your core, reach your legs out, focusing on your breath. Couple more rounds of belly breaths in your nose, out of your nose. Lower back down, shake it out one more time. Coming to stillness. We're going to take our fingerprints, one fingerprint up, one palm print up, curling our toes under, push up off your knees, and come into your first down dog. And your down dog, you want your fingertips pointed forward. Shoulder blades roll away from each other, pushing your chest into your thighs into your chest. Send your hips up to the sky, let your head and neck fall. If you choose to, paddle right to left. Or sway back and forth, whatever feels good. Waking up those calf muscles, walk your dog. Check in with your body, where are you holding any tension? Breathe into that spot. Take a look at your hands and slowly walk your feet in, coming into a forward fold. Lean into your toes, grab your block if you choose to use it. Allow your head and neck to fall. Focus on your breath. Uttanasana. Inhale in reverse, one leg up. Hands come up overhead, palms come together. Take your right hand on your left wrist, inhaling your body up nice and tall. Exhale down and over to the right. Keep your hips squared forward, pulling on your left wrist with your right hand. Breathe into your left side body. Back to center. Switch the cross of your arms, inhaling up. Exhale down. Back to center. Taking a deep inhale. Exhale and swan dive forward, coming back to your toes, allowing everything to hang. Just focus on your breath, set your belly button towards your spine, lean into your toes, release your head and neck. Inhale into flat backs, hands come to your thighs, bodies parallel to the mat. Tuck your belly button towards your spine, your legs, grabbing your ankles, pull yourself in. Tuck your belly button toward your spine. Each exhale, pull your chest closer to your knees. Just fold yourself in half. Bend your knees, placing your palms flat. Step your right foot down, bend your left. Find a plank pose, nice and strong. Shoulders over wrists, tightening your core. Take a deep inhale. Exhaling, you can lower down through a chaturanga or drop your knees and then lower your chest. Uncurl your toes. We're going to tighten our core, bringing our shoulder blades towards one another, keeping neutral spine by looking at the mat. Not hold your breath here, use it. Each exhale, tighten your core. Push your feet into the mat. Baby cobra. Lifting our feet up off the mat for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower flat. Take a nice cleansing breath here. Take a look at your hands and walk your feet back in. Come back to your forward fold. Lean into your toes, focus on your breath. You may notice you're touching the mat a little closer than you were when you first started class. Keep using that belly breath. Inhaling in reverse, long diving up. Hands come up overhead, palms come together, but just for an inhale. Take it all in. Exhale, release it all back to your mat. Nice and controlled. Warming our bodies up with some meditation. Just let everything hang. Take a few rounds of breath. Forward fold is the best pose for migraines. Just allowing everything to flow the opposite way. Inhale to flat backs, nice long spines, bodies parallel to the mat. Tuck your belly button towards your spine, leaning into your toes. Focus on your breath. Halfway lift. Take a nice deep inhale. Exhale, drag your hands down, grab your ankles, pull yourself in. Tuck your belly button towards your spine with each exhale, pulling your chest closer to your knees. Option to sway back and forth here if you choose. Whatever feels good to you this evening. Into stillness. Bend your knees, placing your palms flat. Step your right foot back and then your left. Find your plank pose, shoulders over wrists, tightening your core. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, lower down through your chaturanga or drop your knees and then lower your chest. Uncurl your toes. You can pull up to full cobra, up dog, or if you're new to class, you can hit baby cobra one more time. Whatever feels good. Use your breath, engage your core. Lower flat to your mat, curl your toes under, pull back up to your down dog. Take a nice cleansing breath here. We're going to inhale our right leg up, pointing our toes, squaring our hips forward, coming into three-legged dog. We're going to rock down and work to bring our right knee to our right wrist. hold over your leg. You can come to your block, your forearms, or your head. Or you can place your head on a block. Focus on flexing those toes. If this is too much for you, you can come onto your back, and I'll come show you a modification. I'll do it here too. So on our backs, if it feels better, take your right foot over your left, flexing your toe. Interlace your fingers underneath your left leg, pushing your right hip open. Lean back on your mat and just focus on your breath. And when we go to switch, you can stay on your back and just switch your legs. Whatever feels good to you. Pigeon pose is a great hip opener, and anything that releases your hip also releases your lower back. Be mindful of flexing those toes. Give me a few more rounds of breath here. If you are in pigeon pose, push back to your palms, curling your back toe under, step back to your down dog. If you are on the ground, we're going to roll our feet back, come to our hands and knees, and push down to down dog. Everybody's in down dog. We're going to slowly start to walk our hands back to our feet. Heel toeing our feet to hips width distance apart. Grab your elbows and swing side to side like a rag doll. Just allow everything to hang. Focus on your breath. Overhead, palms come together. Bring your palms down to heart center and take a nice cleansing breath. Take a drink here if you need to. We're going to go into our ab sequence. Just meet me at the back of your mat facing the front of the room. I'm going to face you guys today just so I'm clear on video. So toes, knees, guys, all touching. We're going to roll our shoulders back. Begin to walk your hands down your body, down your mat, and find a plank pose. Shoulders over ribs, tighten your core, round your shoulders, pushing yourself away from the mat, push out through your heels. I'm going to walk through and make sure everyone's good. I want to lean forward, so we're putting all of that weight on our palms. Lift that arm on the hips. Interlacing your fingers. Interlacing our fingers. Stack your shoulders up over your elbows. Pulling up into a modified down dog. We're going to plank out. Inhaling up. Exhaling down. Nice and controlled. Making sure you're coming parallel to the mat. And right back up. Engage your core. Rotate those shoulders. Back and forth. We do 30 in this class. If you're new to them, give me 5. 5 feels good. Go to 10. Feel yourself out. These are difficult. You guys are doing great. And eye on your elbows. Make sure your elbows are staying under your shoulder. We don't want to injure our lower back. We put most of the weight in our arms, moving up and down. If you're in back bend, make sure you're tucking your chin to your chest as you lower flat to the mat. Everybody coming flat to the mat with control. Take a nice cleansing breath. Let it all out. Interlacing our fingers out in front. Push your palms out, rocking side to side, stretching out your wrists. Flip your palms towards one another and do a slow circle 8 in each direction. Massaging your wrists. Tucking your knees into your spine, do a slow roll on your spine. arranged in stillness. You can either interlace your fingers, placing them behind your head, or place your palms underneath your lower back. Extend your legs out, pointing your toes, inhaling to lift, exhaling to hover over the mat. Coming into leg lifts, aiming for 20. Doing as many as you can handle with perfect form.
Thank you.
your front leg. We're going to heel toe the back foot in. So we're heel to arch line, just a little closer together. You can grab a block if you want to use it, but try not to rely on the block because we want to keep a nice long spine. So we're going to inhale to lengthen our spine. Exhale to push your hip back, leaning forward, and simply just coming down, rotating down, hanging over that leg. We're not breaking the space between our leg and our rib cage. We're keeping it nice and long. Take your gaze up towards your top middle finger, rotating from your hips to open up your chest. Keep breathing here. You can support your right hand on a block if it becomes too much without breaking your chest. Bend your front knee, push up off your palm, return to standing safely. We're going to take both of our legs and bring them a little closer together. Both toes pointed forward. So we want to be heel to heel aligned. So if there was a line right here, both your heels would be on it. Rotate your hips forward, inhaling your arms up. Exhale down and over your straight right leg. Allow your head and neck to fall. Use a block here if you need it. Pushing your chest towards your thigh with each exhale. Coming into pyramid pose. You should feel this down the back side of your right leg. Bend your front knee, step your left foot forward, lining up your toes. Keep a slight bend in your knees, interlacing your fingers behind your back. Slowly rise and straighten your legs, allowing your head and neck to fall, focusing on pulling your hands towards the wall in front of you. Coming into a shoulder stretch. Let everything hang. Extend your front leg, heel toe your back foot in, heel to arch line, just a little closer together. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale, push your hip back, lean leaning forward and coming down. Not trying to hit the ground. We'll break our chest. Just simply rotating from the hips to open up the chest. Take the gaze up if it's available. Triangle pose on the left side. Bend your front knee. We're going to slowly rise back to standing, nice and controlled. Take your right toes to meet your left. Well, not meet, but just face forward. So that we're heel to heel aligned. Rotating your hips forward. Inhale your arms up. Exhale down and over your left leg. Pyramid pose on the opposite side. Let your head and neck fall. Breathe into your tight spot. Push your chest towards your thighs. Bend your front knee. Step your right foot forward, lining up your toes. We're slowly going to roll up one vertebrae at a time. Rise with your head relaxed. Hands come up overhead. Palms come together. Bring your palms down to heart center and take a nice cleansing breath. We're going to go into our balancing poses. So just take a drink if you need to. If not, we're just going to find ourselves in abdominal stance. So you want your feet to be hips width distance apart, rolling your shoulders down your back, chins are parallel to the mat. Bring all of your weight onto your left foot, right foot comes out. You can leave it right here. This is a great place to start. You can bring it in at your ankle, up to your shin, or all the way on your thigh. As long as you're not placing it on your knee. Square your hips forward, engage your back muscles, find your focus point, focusing on your breath. If you're swaying, tighten that belly button towards your core, or towards your spine, I'm sorry. Find that focus point and lift up. Growing your limbs here if you choose. Coming into full tree. Lower your arms back down, remove your right foot, roll your left ankle up direction. Coming back to mountain stance. Take a nice cleansing breath. All of your weight comes onto your right foot. Left foot comes up, you can leave it right here. Take it to your ankle, up to your shin, or all the way on your thigh. Long as you're not placing it on your knee. Engage your back muscles, finding your focus point. Focus on your breath. Growing your limbs if you choose. Coming into full tree. Lower your arms back down, removing your left foot, roll your right ankle out of both directions. We're going to take ourselves to our mats. We're going to find a nice tall seat. Stack your ankles up in front of yourself. Roll your shoulders down your back, nice tall posture. We're going to take the left foot into the left hand, pulling it up into a heel stretch. Pulling it back, opening up your hip, and then we're going to cross it over, coming into Ugly Baby. This is a variation of Pigeon Pose. It's a little awkward. You feel it right here. You don't have to bring it all the way to your chest. You can have it right here. Or if this is too much, you can cross right over left and push yourself towards your legs, flexing that right toe. Or left toe. Sorry. Just lift up and sway back and forth if you choose. Just a few more breaths here. Start to lower that back down. Then a nice tall seat in between. Right foot into the right hand. Inhale it up. Pull it back. Cross it over. Flex those right toes. Nice tall posture. Try not to lean to your leg. Bring your leg to your chest. Rock it if you choose. Or just simply stay still and focus on the stretch. Deep inhales in your nose. Open mouth exhales. Start to lower back down. We're going to tuck our knees to our chest. We're going to roll our knees down and over to the right side. Right hand comes over your knee. Look up over your left palm, keeping your shoulders pinned to the mat. With each exhale, breathing those knees down and over to the right side, coming into a belly twist. Belly twists are good for your digestive system. They also help to open up your sinuses. Tuck your knees back to your chest. Roll them down and over to the left side. Left hand over your knee. Look out over your right palm. Belly twist on the opposite side. Does anybody have any negative reaction or not wanting to sit from Shavasana? Just raise your hand off the mat. Choose to stay still, focusing on pulling those thighs towards the mat. Or you can rock back and forth and massage your spine. Whatever feels good to you. You can take the last couple moments here. Just do that pose. You can stay in Happy Baby. You can do another belly twist on each side. Maybe a shoulder stand. Maybe you're just crossing one arm over the other, stretching out those shoulders. Whatever feels good. Get nice and comfortable on your mat. And when you're ready, bring your hands down by your sides, palms facing up for better relaxation, or facing down if you need to feel more grounded tonight. Next few moments, I'm going to walk you through a guided meditation focusing on your breath. With your eyes closed, begin to connect with the inner world of thoughts and feeling. Gradually, the external world will fade from your awareness. For the next few minutes, give yourself permission to enjoy this relaxing experience. You are free from all responsibility at this time. So put aside any thoughts of tasks, concerns, anything that may be waiting for you. Let it go. If you find that your mind wanders during this meditation, simply bring your awareness back to the sound of my voice, and I will guide you to a place of deep relaxation and inner stillness. Remember that you are always in control. If you wish to stop at any time, you can do so by simply opening your eyes. Now take a long, slow, deep breath in. And then release that breath. Feel yourself relax. Again, take a long, slow, deep breath in. And then let that breath go. Take another deep breath in. And exhale completely. Notice how calm it is to breathe this. Of relaxation that is beginning to spread throughout your whole body. Continue to slowly, deeply, gently. With each breath you take, your thoughts become lighter. You may sense a feeling of spaciousness opening up inside of you. Relax. Allow the gentle movement of your breath to guide you into an even more relaxed state. In and out, and deeper you go. Breathing in and out. You are now in a state of relaxation, and it's time to enjoy a guided journey to an inner place of serenity and bliss. As I speak, just allow images to form in your mind naturally in your own time. If pictures do not come easily to you, simply sense the image surroundings rather than. Of all expectations and allow yourself to experience this guided journey in whatever way it comes naturally to you. Standing in a beautiful grassy field, you can feel the warmth of the sun on your face and your body. Green grass soft beneath. You can hear the sounds of nature around you. You are very much at home in this peaceful place. You have all the time in the world here, and you feel safe and happy. Take a moment to appreciate your surroundings. You notice a large tree growing nearby. Begin to walk towards the tree. Take your time, be in the moment, and experience each step. As you walk, feel yourself slipping. more deeply into a state of total relaxation. Now you stand beneath the tree. Its strong branches and broad leaves hang over your head. Notice that the tree is covered in delicious fruits of many sizes, shapes, and colors. This is no ordinary tree. Its fruits contain special powers. Reach up and take a piece of fruit from the tree. Study it for a moment. Notice the color, the texture, the weight of it in your hand. Now take a bite. As the fruit slides down your throat into your stomach, something wonderful begins to happen. A feeling of happiness begins to glow deep inside of you. The sensation begins in your stomach and it spreads to your chest and to your heart. Let go of thinking and concentrate on the feeling. Happiness and love. Feel yourself gently glowing with it. Take another bite of fruit now. Taste it, savor it. Now this wonderful feeling will intensify a little more. Feel yourself gently radiating with this pleasant sensation of love and happiness. Now take your third bite of fruit. Take as much as you want. Relax and allow yourself to swell up with this delightful feeling. Don't try. Let it rise effortlessly within you. Allow it to increase as much as you would like. Stay with these blissful feelings and enjoy this time of peaceful meditation. Begin to bring feeling into your fingers and your toes, giving them a light ripple. Take a deep stretch overhead while keeping your eyes peeled. Roll onto your right side, knees to your chest, taking three cleansing breaths. As you inhale, inhale love to yourself, and as you exhale, exhale love to others. Take your time coming to a tall, seated position, no rush. Eyes are sealed. We're going to take our chins to our chest and do a nice slow neck roll in each direction. Noticing how you feel now and comparing it to the beginning of our class. Finding a nice tall seat when you're finished, eyes are still sealed. Bring your hands into heart center, taking a nice deep inhale, open up, exhale. awareness can be unstoppable, or you can just listen. Everyone inhaling. Thank you all for coming and practicing with me this evening. The light in me honors and respects the light in each of you. Namaste. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
If one of these lights turn on, if you borrow the mat, just leave it on the ground. I'll come back and put it off.
Well, namaste to everybody out there, and thank you all very much for doing yoga with us tonight, and happy wishing. See you guys later.
I'm just